in the DNA of Western is the fact that students come first. We are here because we want to see our students succeed. We are a place where a lot of first-generation students come. They'll be the first in their families to get that college degree, which is a great investment in the future.
One of the things that's special about this program, 25 of the 39 national letters of intent signed to play football came from people right here in the state of Oregon.
About 80% of our student body is Oregonians, and we take pride in the fact that we're accessible and affordable. Students that are going to major in life, this is the vast majority of them. The very best have a chance to perhaps play professional sports, but the vast majority are going to go on and do something great, and that means graduate. And so that's just a huge opportunity for us to see our student athletes lead the way. Go Wolves!
That is building for Western Oregon as a program is on full display now.
Walsh walks it in! Touchdown!
I got this.
Turn it up.
Jason Slowey, the tackle from Western Oregon, just went from the famed Tom Brady pick, 199 overall.
Terrell Williams out of Western Oregon.
One thing you cannot teach is speed, and Tyrell Williams has shown that he has excellent top-end speed.
You know, probably the most impressive thing that I've seen with Tyrell is the way he's worked after practice. You know, he stays after practice. He works, you know, running routes, working on technique and footwork. And I really respect that because you just never know when your number is going to be called in this business.
Here's Rivers looking down the field, wide open. He's got a man wide open, it's Williams. Somehow he got free in the secondary, and he jogs into the end zone to put the Chargers back in front. 80 yards, Rivers to Tyrell Williams.
Tyrell Williams, you might remember the senior a year ago wearing number 18, made the 53-man roster in San Diego this year.
Cause I got a really big team, and they need some really big rings. They need some really nice things. Better be coming with no strings. Better be coming with no strings. We need some really nice things. We need some really big rings. I got a really big team.
Left side, he'll cut away to the 40. He's got room to run. He's got all the room. 20, 15, 10. He'll go to the end zone. It'll be a 44-yard touchdown run for Malik Braxton.
I got a really big team, man. What?
Travis might have a chance to get underneath this one. Gets away from one tackler, now out to the outside, running up the middle, looking for a lane, looking to the outside, and no one is there. Paul Revis to the house. Touchdown, Wolves! Wow.
Second field goal attempt, Steve. And it's a fake, or maybe a bad snap. Revis has it. He's got nowhere to run. He's looking for a room. He's going to pass it. Man wide open in the end zone, and it's a touchdown for the Wolves! Recreation from Arn Ferguson.
Are you talking about a player that dove for a ball and caught it for 50 yards and a person that passed for a touchdown in the first half? What can't Paul Revis do, or what won't Paul Revis do for this team?
And I got a really big team, and they need some really big rings. They need some really nice things. Better be coming with no strings. Better be coming with no strings. We need some really nice things. We need some really big rings. I got a really big team.
Oregon, thank you for joining us for a big non-conference matchup between Western Oregon University and the University of North Alabama and their number 6 ranking. This is a pedigree program, Steve, that's coming all the way across the country. It's the winningest program in the entire state over the last 25 years. And now, Philip Panumiai, number 13, will come out to run this high-power, high-octane spread offense featuring Malik Braxton.
Certainly. With Malik Braxton running back for Western Oregon Wolves, there's always the opportunity for explosion plays.
The yard line flushed out, spin behind. He's got a man open. It's Agby. Agby jumps. It's a touchdown for the Wolves.
defensive fall.